To reduce barriers to learning, it is important to ensure that information is understandable for all learners, including those that may be visually impaired. Alternative text, that is alt text, is a way to make graphics understandable. Graphics may be a chart, clip art, or an image, for example. Alt text is used to communicate the purpose of a graphic for learners with visual impairments or that cannot see the image for whatever reason. It is important to remember that you may have a student that will not see your content. The student may only hear it. Upon completion of this tutorial, you will know how to add alt text to a graphic so that the text conveys the purpose for including the graphic. Towards the end of this tutorial, I'll also include important information about null alt text that is used for graphics that are purely presentational. To demonstrate how to add alt text for your graphics, I'll use the syllabus word template that I downloaded from the GRCC website at grcc.edu/syllabus. I already customized parts of this syllabus for my course, changed some of the formatting, and made a few additions. I'm using Word 2013 to view and edit this syllabus, but most of the features are similar in other more recent versions of Word, other word processing applications, and on a Mac or PC. Relevant graphics can increase comprehension and usability for most students. However, without alternative alt text, some learners will not understand what the graphic is or the purpose of it. Without alt text, a screen reader may read the file name or give the student the dimensions of the graphic instead. Either scenario is not very helpful to a person using a screen reader. If you could not see this image of the textbook and only heard book.jpg, horizontal pixels 150, vertical pixels 188, would this be helpful for you? Probably not. What I need to do is add alt text to convey the purpose of including this image in the syllabus. In a previous video tutorial, I added this image of the textbook in the required materials section of the syllabus. I also linked the image to the Cengage Brain website so that the student can find information about the textbook and other information from the publisher. To make the image a hyperlink, I selected the image. Next, I clicked the Insert tab and then the Hyperlink button. What I'll do next is add alt text to this image. First, I'm going to minimize the ribbon as it's taken a lot of room on my screen. I just double-clicked one of the tabs on the top of the screen to minimize the ribbon. To add the alt text, I'll right-click the image, and from the shortcut menu all the way at the bottom, I'll choose Format Picture. This opens the Format Picture task pane on the right side of the screen. In the task pane, the third icon from the left is Layout and Properties. I'll click the Layout and Properties icon. After I do, I'll need to click Alt Text to expand it so that I can see the title and description fields. This is how you get to the Alt Text options in Word 2013. It is slightly different in Word 2010. Here is the same syllabus viewed in Word 2010. To access the alt text attributes, again I'll select the image, right click, and from the shortcut menu choose Format Picture. After I choose Format Picture, this opens up the Format Picture dialog box. On the left side, on the lower left, I'll click Alt Text. Alt text is added the same way in other Microsoft applications as well. For example, the alt text is added to a PowerPoint image too by right-clicking the image. Now that you know how to access the alt text options in both versions of Word, I'll switch back to 2013. In the Format Picture task pane on the right, I have a title and description fields to add alt text. There are a few things to keep in mind when determining what alt text to include. Alt text that provides a good description will convey the purpose for including the graphic. I am more concerned with describing the purpose rather than the appearance of the graphic. It is a good idea to not repeat the same information in the surrounding text, as it is repetitive. A person using a screen reader should not have to listen to the same information twice. For graphics that are linked, try to avoid words such as link to, as screen readers already identify links for the user. It would be redundant to provide that information in the alt text. When a screen reader encounters a graphic that is also a link, it will actually say link to alert the user. Back in my Word 2013 syllabus document, I'll add the description for the alt text. I already copied the alt text to the clipboard to save time, so I'll go ahead and paste it here in the description box. The alt text that I pasted into the description box says information about the required textbook and other resources are available from the publisher's website at cengagebrain.com. Notice that I clearly provide the purpose for including the image, and in this case I provided the website address too. I did not say click here or link to or click the picture of the textbook because I know the screen reader will already let the student know that this is a link. Note the title field. I recommend you leave this field blank. There is one advantage to using it, however, there are more disadvantages for making use of this field. One advantage of entering a brief title is that the screen reader will read it first, and then the learner can decide whether they want to hear the longer description too. So that could save time. And some say to be safe, enter both a brief title and then a longer detailed description. One of the issues with using both the title and the description is that if I later decide to convert this Word document into, say, another type of file, HTML, hypertext markup language, the conversion process will combine the title and the description into a single value. Sometimes this can result in extra and possibly redundant verbiage. A couple of other reasons to leave the title blank include backwards compatibility and how third-party tools may interpret these two fields. If this document is opened in Microsoft Office Word 2007 or earlier, the title is dropped. The title is not supported in older versions of Word. Likewise, some third-party tools that may be used to convert Office documents utilize only the description, not the title. So bottom line, I recommend that you use the description field only and leave the title field blank for alt text. At this time, I will also mention the use of graphics that are purely presentational, that is, that do not provide any meaningful information. People that can see a decorative graphic may just skip over it. People that are using screen readers should be able to skip over the graphic too. In this syllabus, I added a decorative clip art for the grading procedure section. I'll scroll down to that section now. Other purely presentational graphics may include borders or bullets, for example. One important limitation of Microsoft Office is that the software does not make it possible to tell screen readers to ignore a decorative graphic and skip over it. I have tried adding a blank space in the title and the description, but the screen reader still reads the file name and or the dimensions of the image for the students. Because I have found that it's not possible to tell screen readers to skip over decorative graphics and prevent it from reading image data to the learner, I recommend to not use decorative graphics at all in Microsoft Office documents. Therefore, I'll go ahead and delete the decorative graphic that I have here. Decorative graphics should not be included because of the issue that I mentioned, but also if the graphic is not relevant to the content, it may be only a distraction anyway. For purposes of clarification, if this syllabus were available in HTML, hypertext markup language, instead of Microsoft Word, I can add a null or what is also called an empty alt text. In the HTML, I can add a one-side image element with an alt attribute that has an empty value. And then the screen reader will just ignore the image. Again, this is not possible in Microsoft Word documents. Fortunately, you do not need to know HTML to convert your Word documents. I'll demonstrate how to convert a Word document to HTML in a later tutorial. It's actually a simple conversion process, a simple matter of copy and paste. I'll also demonstrate how to add a graphic to a content area in Blackboard and add empty alt text if you really wish to have a decorative graphic. To summarize, I demonstrated how to add alt text to a graphic. I used an image of the required textbook in the syllabus as an example. To reduce barriers to learning, it is important to ensure that the information is understandable for all learners, including those that may be visually impaired. Alt text is another way for your graphics to be understood in the document. To add alt text to an image, select the image, right-click, and then choose Format Picture from the shortcut menu. If using Microsoft Office 2013, the next step is to click the Layout and Properties button. If using Office 2010, the next step is to click the Alt Text option. Good alt text will convey the purpose of the image. It is also a good idea to not repeat the same information in the surrounding text of the document. If the image is also linked, avoid using words like link to or click here or similar wording, as screen readers already alert the user when there is a link. Consider using the description field only for the alt text, not the title field. Using the description only may prevent issues with backward compatibility and how third-party tools may interpret these fields. It will also prevent issues if I later decide to convert this Word document to HTML. Avoid using images that are purely presentational in your Microsoft Office documents. Decorative bullets, borders, dividers, clip art, for example, do not provide additional meaning, and there's not a way to tell the screen reader to skip over them in Microsoft Word. In HTML, null alt text can be used to tell a screen reader to skip over the image. However, this is not possible in Microsoft Office.